Hello everyone, I'm Rachel from the Innisfil Idea Lab and Library, and in today's Tinkershop tutorial, we're going to learn how to design 3D printed earrings. We're going to be using the website TinkerCAD. You can create your own account. And when you first enter the work platform, you can see a grid here. Using the left button on your mouse, you can click and drag options to the design platform. And you can click and select to make things bigger or smaller, or move them and drag them. The right button on your mouse can help you change your view. To the left of your screen, you can zoom in, you can zoom out, you can click the home button, and you can zoom in right to your piece. To the right-hand side of your toolbars, you can see a variety of different shapes. You can click the drop-down menu and select different options as well. These shapes that have these gray stripes are known as holes, and they can help you cut through different kinds of objects by placing it over top of one object and grouping them together. Up at the top of your toolbar, you'll have group, ungroup, alignment, and you can also flip and mirror your objects. Below that, you can select different colors, and you can also turn any shape into a hole. Today, while we create our earrings, we're going to use basic shapes, and we're going to also convert those shapes into holes to make more designs. Begin clicking and dragging your shapes to the work platform. A menu will appear where you can change the radius of your shape. You can also change the wall thickness, change the sides. You can also give it a beveled edge if you like, which is a nice feature. When your shape is highlighted, you'll notice there's white dots here, and these white dots will help you make your object bigger or smaller, or you can type in the dimensions by clicking the numbers here at the bottom. You can also make it taller or shorter. You can also squish your shape. You can also rotate your shape, and there should be another arrow here where you can also rotate it on its side. And there is also a little triangle here that can help you elevate it. You also have the option to copy your shapes. So I'm going to just adjust a couple of different sizes here, and I'm going to begin overlaying a few basic shapes. So I'm just selecting my shapes. I'm going to make a couple more copies and some smaller ones as well. So we've created our first earring that's using pretty much just the ring shape right here. Now, right now, they are all separate different pieces. We want to group this together. So I'm going to click and draw a box around all of my objects. Now I'm going to group them together. As we zoom in, we can get an idea of what our earrings are going to look like. And if we wanted to make a copy, just simply copy and paste it. And we can even mirror that object so it kind of looks a little bit more symmetric. So that's one way of designing some earrings. Now, if we wanted to go ahead and make these thinner, we can also do that. How do you do two objects at once? Just select one, hold down your shift key, and select the other one. Thinner or adjust them to be the same size, you can do that now and they should automatically be in sync. Now, if you want to know what your size of your object is, you can click on it and it's going to give you right here, I believe in millimeters, how big your object is. Okay, so let's make another set of earrings, but this one we're going to use a triangle shape and then also use the hole tool to cut out shapes from that. I'm just going to use this one as my triangle one. I'm going to make it a little thinner. And we're going to stretch this one out too. Now I'm going to turn it. We're going to turn it again too on its side. I'm just clicking and dragging and rotating my mouse kind of to the way I want it. Let's make this one a little bit bigger and I'm going to make a copy, but this time I'm going to click the hole option and I'm going to make it smaller just a little bit so that way it's going to fit inside my other triangle. So I'm just going to create a square around everything, and then I'm going to group it together, and this should cut out my square piece. And I'm going to click on it again, and I'm going to make some more copies. And again, you can rotate them. You can get kind of creative with these. Okay, so I've created some shapes here. I'm going to highlight them all together again, and I'm going to group them. Now this one has a bit of different levels, but that's also something we can use for our design. So I'm going to make a copy, and I'm going to mirror it, so it's the opposite way. And you could also overlap them and group them again if you'd like. I'm going to select both of these, and I'm just going to make them a little bit smaller. So we've just done some with some shapes. Now let's import an image. You can also upload images by going to Import, choosing a file, which is either an STL, an OBJ, or an SVG. Choose File, Upload. Hit Open. And here you have an option to arrange the size and the scale. And hit Import. It'll just take a second. Now, say you have an object like this and you want to insert some holes. Use your cylinder tool, and we're just going to make it a lot smaller and thinner. You're going to hover it over top of your object. Change your view to make sure that it's right in place. You're going to select, hold down shift and select your object and group that together. I'm going to hold down shift and select multiple objects, and then I'm going to group them all together. I've been able to make a little circle here. So now that we have all of our earrings in place, we want to export our design. We're going to go to export in the top right hand corner. We do have a few options of how to save our design. We can do an OBJ, an object file, an STL. We can also do an SVG. Today we're going to save it as an STL because we're going to be doing it for 3D printing. Okay, and your item is now saved. So today we just learned how we can design earrings for the 3D printer. Again, my name is Rachel from the Innisfil Idea Lab and Library, and thank you so much for joining us. Take care.